Welcome to the Vitality Show. My name's Nana Akwir. This is Fitness TV. Now, I'm here with Patrick Holford. He did a talk last year, and we had it on the channel, and he's going to do another talk this year, Vitality. So tell us a bit about the talk.
This talk is about how to surf the silver tsunami.
Oh.
It's called 10 Secrets to Healthy Aging.
Okay.
And the truth is we're living longer, but we're not living healthier.
Okay.
Average woman in the EU has 9.8 years of disability.
Okay.
And it doesn't have to be like this. So we learn how to manage our money, maybe how to cook, maybe how to garden, maybe how to keep fit.
Yes.
But we don't really learn how to do aging well. So in my talk, I'm going to explain how to do healthy aging.
Okay.
It's about diet, it's about exercise, it's about attitude, it's about sleep. And also, the older you get, the more of certain nutrients you need. Two of the myths I'm going to be exploding are, number one, you don't need supplements. You can get it all from your diet.
That's not true.
It's not true. The older you get, the more you need. And I'm going to be showing the ones that stop your brain from shrinking.
Well,
so
that's important.
Alzheimer's
yes.
is a preventable disease. And I'm also going to be exploding the myth that it's all in your genes. Because the recent science shows that you can actually affect what's called genetic expression. You can switch on anti-aging genes. You can add at least 10 years to your healthy life, but I think just as importantly is to add life to your years.
Okay.
And that's what I'm going to be explaining. And the book's called 10 Secrets of Healthy Aging.
Oh, Patrick, that sounds phenomenal. So guess how old I am then?
Oh, I look about 21.
Yeah, that's very good. He's good. 40. I'm 40.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm 54.
Really? Is that
yeah.
Yeah, Patrick, you're looking good.
Yeah.
Well, we're looking forward to your talk, Patrick. Stick around, check it out. It's next.
My name is Patrick Holford, and it was my birthday yesterday. Thank you very much. I'm 54 years old, and my wife and my lovely two kids made an amazing feast using as much as they could from my garden, including my first carrot and a delicious chocolate cake that was low GL, dairy-free and wheat-free, but I suspect rather high in calories. I'm author of a book. I thought I had one. Could you give me one? It's not out yet, officially. It's not out till April the 5th. But I twisted the arm of my publishers, and we have it here for the very first time ever in the UK. And it's called 10 Secrets of Healthy Aging, and it's co-authored by Jerome Byrne, who just won the Best Medical Journalist of the Year award. And the reason we wrote this book is that if you do nothing to change your health, the picture is a little bit bleak. From the age of 40 onwards, you lose your muscle mass at a rate of 1% a year. So your granny should be doing weights or something to build muscle. From 50 onwards, your hormonal levels decline, and that has all sorts of consequences. And over 65, that's really the watershed. That's when most heart attacks, diagnoses of cancer, and so on kick in. And by then, half of people have osteoarthritis. And by 80, your risk of having dementia, Alzheimer's, is 1 in 5. And your risk of fractures is high. And in Britain, we have a 5-a-day policy. You probably know this. By the time you're 65, you're likely to be on 5 medications, prescription drugs. And by the time you're 75, it could easily be 10. And the reason Jerome and I wrote this book is that we believe that learning how to age well is an essential life skill. You learn how to manage your money, perhaps, how to cook, perhaps how to garden, maybe how to play golf. I don't, I'm still sexually active. But who teaches you how to age well? If you run your house and you don't maintain it, after a while something will break and you have to call in the plumber at vast expense, or the electrician, that is your doctor. as you get older, when something breaks, you're channeled into the medical system. It's very expensive, but it's not really prevention. And the more drugs people are on, the more problems occur because drugs are not team players. In America, medical intervention has become the third leading cause of death. Now, what is happening is we are living longer, but we have less healthy years and more years of decrepitude. It has got to the point where the average woman in the EU will spend 9.8 years of their life disabled. And very genuinely, I don't want you to be one of them. My first real mentor, a wonderful psychiatrist called Dr. Abram Hoffer, who cured more people with schizophrenia than anyone on this planet, and really discovered a lot about what goes wrong in the brain. Last time I saw him, he was limping a little bit, and I said, Abram, you're limping. He said, you know, Patrick, when you're in your 90s, it's harder to maintain your muscle mass, but don't worry, I've got myself a personal trainer book for when I get home. Anyway, he died a couple of years ago, and I asked his dear friend Stephen, please tell me exactly what happened. He said 2 weeks before his death, he stopped seeing patients. And 4 days before his death, he started to feel not too good. And 2 days before, he checked into the local hospital. He didn't have diabetes, heart disease, osteoporosis, Alzheimer's, or any disease as such. His organs just shut down, and he died at peace, not in pain, with no medication, in his 90s. Yes, you can probably add at least 10 years to your healthy lifespan, but I think even more important is to add, you know, life to your years. Now, it's looking as if doing enough things in combination is going to make a big difference. This was a study out of Cambridge University. And people who did 4 things, didn't smoke, light drinkers, kept physically active, ate 5 or more servings of fruit and veg a day, lived 14 years longer than people who did smoke, drank, didn't eat fruit and veg, and weren't fit. This is the EU's year of active aging, because in case you haven't realized, with so many more people, the baby boomers, I mean, this is about how to surf the silver tsunami, as we call it, because there are so many baby boomers born in the 40s and 50s who are now hitting their 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s. It's an economic nightmare. So the EU have a year of active aging, and they recognize we have to find a way of keeping older people healthy, and they've launched a study looking at the effects of vitamin D, omega-3, and home exercises. The results we will know in a decade or so. I'll talk about why those. So in researching this book, The 10 Secrets of Healthy Aging, we have a pyramid. And I want to touch on these. We have a little bit of time together. I'm going to go fast. Optimum nutrition, your diet, exercise, sleep, relaxation, positive attitude, nutritional supplements, in some cases natural hormones and sunlight. I will explain. On our website, patrickholford.com, we've built a free bio-age check. You should all do it. It's really good. It takes you about 20 minutes. Fill out a questionnaire, and it works out your biological age and also what to do about it. And one of the things we look at is something called homocysteine. It's terribly important. I'll touch on it later, but if your level goes up, your risk for many things goes up, including your brain shrinking, your bone shrinking, and your heart disease risk. If you said, give me one blood test I should have, I would say that, and I would also say your glycosylated hemoglobin. I'll talk about this later. This is to do with your blood sugar. This is true prevention. If you know those two figures, you know a lot. But you'll also be asked when you're doing the questionnaire to do something like sit up without your arms. How easy is that? Stand on one leg. So there are measures of strength and flexibility and various things that you can do with a simple test. It's well worth doing. You also get a score out of 100%. And you want to be above 80% health. And only 6% of people are when they start. But when they finish, that's a whole different story. You can really think of aging as to do with cells. We are made out of trillions of cells, brain cells, skin cells, muscle cells, liver cells. They look like this. This bit in the middle is the nucleus. That's where the blueprint, the DNA, the genes are contained. And you've got to copy that to make a new cell. This, for example, is called a mitochondria. It's a little energy factory, a mitochondria. And it turns your food into energy. And we produce exhaust fumes. And the older you get, the less functional cells become, just like a factory that's, you know, many years old. You're going to need more antioxidants for the mitochondria to work. You're going to need more B vitamins, for reasons I'll explain, to read your DNA. And I thought I would just go through some of the things that you just do need more of when you age. You can also think of aging like photocopying a photocopy of a photocopy. So when you copy the genetic information in the nucleus, you do it with a process called methylation. Methylation depends on B vitamins, and especially B6, B12, and folic acid. What you've got here are two people, same age, in their 70s. And the one on the right has a homocysteine level. Just think of gay chapel if you forget the word. Homocysteine, okay? Of 7.8, which is pretty good. And the one on the right has a homocysteine of 13.1. They've had an MRI brain scan done at a 6-month interval. One scan is put over the other. There's no change here. There's no loss of brain mass. What you see in black here is dead brain cells. This is Alzheimer's disease. It's a very specific destruction of a certain part of the brain. There is no way back. But there is a way to stop this. And you need to know now, not when it's too late and you forgot what I was talking about. For a minute, ignore the red and look at the blue. This is a study, a very important study that came out last year that proves that you can stop accelerated brain shrinkage and memory decline. You can stop it. And what they did in this study was they took people with what's called mild cognitive impairment, that's the step before dementia or Alzheimer's, and they measured the rate of their brain shrinkage, and they measured their homocysteine level, and they split them into a quarter with the lowest homocysteine going up to the highest. And as you can see, the higher was the homocysteine, the greater was the rate of brain shrinkage. They then gave half of them placebos, dummy pills, and half of them B vitamins. And that's the ones in the red. And what you can see here is that you don't get that high level of brain shrinkage. I should point out that a brain shrinkage at this level is what you see in healthy people with no memory decline. So especially in those with a raised homocysteine, it more than halved, you know, that brain shrinkage. I should point out here that the level of homocysteine above which you get brain shrinkage and also probably bone shrinkage is 9.5. 75% of older people have a level above 9.5, and you may do too. I tested one man who said that he felt brain dead. He kept losing his car in multi-story car parks, and his level was 119. And 1 year later, his level is 9, and he says, I have never in my entire life had so sharp a memory and concentration now at the age of 60. To make it real, here is a person who took the dummy pill. Their brain shrank by 2.5%. The homocysteine went up from 22 to 30. Everything you see in turquoise is lost brain matter. This is a brain scan from the top. So the bit in the middle is an empty hole, it's the top of your spine. Here is a person who took the B vitamins. Their brain shrank by less than 0.5%. The homocysteine went down from 24 to 12. There is no brain shrinkage. So you are probably going to need more B vitamins as you get older, and especially vitamin B12, because it's not easy to absorb. And the older you get, the less secretions you make from the stomach, and you can't absorb it so well. Greens and seeds and nuts and beans are very high in folate, folic acid. That's important brain building B vitamin. Fish and eggs are high in B12. Coffee raises homocysteine. A double espresso by 11% in 4 hours. So if you're on 6 coffees a day, you're going to have a raised homocysteine. But it is supplements, very, very specifically, that lower the brain shrinkage. The amount used in this study was 500 micrograms, the RDA. That's what you read on the cornflakes packet, which stands for the ridiculous dietary arbitrary, is 1 microgram. The level that stops brain shrinkage is 500 times the RDA and completely safe. So there are a number of nutrients that improve methylation. We go into this a lot in the book and tell exactly what to do. You're going to need more antioxidants, and possibly some you haven't heard of, like lipoic acid or coenzyme Q. There is a wonderful man called Professor Bruce Ames, who's one of the top experts in aging. And he developed a model called the triage theory. Now, if you're in battle and you're a surgeon, surgeons know you leave the ones who are going to live anyway, you leave the ones who are going to die anyway, and you focus on the ones you can save. This is called triage. What the human body does as you go through your life with suboptimal nutrition, with maybe not quite enough selenium or vitamin C or whatever, is it will channel those nutrients to the most essential function. So for example, if you're pregnant, it will channel it towards that. But at the cost of background repair and rejuvenation. So you can get away with things in the 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s, but they catch up. If you give animals extra antioxidants, that energy factory called the mitochondria that I showed you earlier, it works better. They have more energy, more physical and mental energy. These antioxidants disarm the exhaust fumes that we make when we burn carbohydrate for energy. So our cells just become less efficient. And you're going to need more of these antioxidants. And there's an exact sequence. And there are two ways you can get them. Actually, I need some now. Cherry Active. Hello. Could I have some? I'm really thirsty. You can either supplement them or you can eat them. And this is vitamin E in fish and seeds, vitamin C in fruit and veg, glutathione in onions and garlic. Anthocyanidines in blue-red foods like cherries, superb. So I have a shot of this every day if I can. And resveratrol is the stuff in red grapes and all the rest. And this man, you were the second, what was the program called again?
Oh, Winter Wipeout.
Winter Wipeout. This man came second on Cherry Actin. And probably twice the age of all the others. Yeah. Thank you, John. resveratrol. Some of these antioxidants are very interesting. Resveratrol actually switches on anti-aging genes. So I want to talk about this. Personally, I supplement all of these every day. And I also eat them every day. I'll talk a bit more about that later. So when my kids made me my lovely birthday dinner last night, you've got something orange like butternut squash, something yellow like mustard, turmeric, something purple like beetroot, blueberries, they had pomegranate, something green. We made these lovely little sort of pancakey things with the chard that grows in my garden. It's also red. So you're really going for all of these strong colors. And in fact, there was a study out today that showed that beetroot lowers your blood pressure. And we know that the longest living people consume a large amount of antioxidants, which you can measure. They're called the ORACs. And you want to have over 6,000 ORACs a day. Cinnamon is good. Dark chocolate in my chocolate birthday cake yesterday. That was very good. Berries, this stuff, 8,360 ORACs. That's about 10 servings of regular fruit and veg. Just one shot of that. Just this is that. red lentils, red kidney beans, red cabbage, red wine, green broccoli, green asparagus, green pistachios. So you're going for the colors. This person here has done their five a day, very good. They had some melon, kiwi, carrot, green peas, and spinach, and clocked up 2,500 ORAKs. This person has gone for pear, strawberries, avocado, broccoli, and asparagus, and clocked up 10,500. So, for those of you who've joined, I'd said, in order to age well, you need to learn how to do it. And the purpose of the book is to show you that. So it's worth studying and realizing that peas are wonderful, but asparagus really delivers the punch. The next thing you're going to need more of as you get older is vitamin D. We're all designed to be naked, living outdoors a lot further south than England. So we don't make enough vitamin D. And here, of course, is a quandary, because you know that a lot of sunlight exposure will age the skin. So what do? I actually put on a vitamin A cream in the morning, which anti-ages your skin, and it protects you from the damage from the sun. And then I make sure, in this weather, I get half an hour of sun exposure on at least my arms and face. And in the sort of midsummer, a quarter of an hour before any sun protection factor. You make most of your vitamin D in the first 15 minutes. And if you can up your vitamin D to 70 nanomoles per liter in your blood, which is most people are around 30, so if you can double your vitamin D in the blood, you have halved your risk of dying of a heart attack, you've cut your risk of cancer infections, and according to a very, very good study, you've added 2 years to your life. And you could probably do this, if you don't want to spend a lot of time outdoors, with one drop of a vitamin D oil, just that. Is it worth 2 years? By the way, vitamin D makes your muscles strong, not just your bones, actually makes the muscles strong. So, a lot of people get backache because the muscles don't support the back and your posture gets worse. You're gonna need more omega-3s. And the omega-3s, the richest vegetarian source, I was just doing an interview in the car on the way over, and in the Independent newspaper tomorrow, there's gonna be an article on chia seeds. Chia seeds are the richest vegetarian source of omega-3. And I'm sure they'll be somewhere here. In fact, I think that stand has chia seeds, I think. The most powerful source of omega-3 is in oily fish. And you probably know how these were discovered, because the Eskimos have the highest intake of fat, the highest intake of cholesterol, and the lowest rate of cardiovascular disease. And it turned out the reason is the plankton in the Arctic water is rich in this stuff. The little fish eat it. The fish with teeth like salmon and mackerel eat the little fish. So they're really producing a lot of this, which is the powerful stuff. And then the seals eat the salmon and the mackerel. And then the Eskimos eat the seals. And that's actually how we found, if you want to have a healthy heart, you eat Eskimos. So this is one of the great things. When you take a drug, it has all these knock-on side effects. But when you take a nutrient like omega-3, perhaps to reduce your risk of a heart attack, you find you become less anxious, your mood improves, your joints stop hurting, it improves your blood sugar control, and your skin becomes really smooth. So nutrients are team players, and they have knock-on effects. You're going to need more zinc and magnesium and selenium as you get older, and most people in Britain, according to the government surveys, are taking in less than 50 micrograms. The recommended intake of selenium is 75 micrograms. So most of us are short-changed. You won't see it, obviously, but it will have an effect on the aging process. So one of the first myths about aging is you do not need supplements. The truth is, you need more nutrients the older you get. Your diet alone does not provide enough. Your absorption gets worse with age. Drugs rob your body of nutrients. And in animal studies, it's very clear that higher amounts do extend healthy function and lifespan. And the very nutrients that you would use to slow down the aging process are exactly the same nutrients that are going to reduce your risk for serious diseases. has been hijacked by the pharmaceutical industry. I was in a conference 2 weeks ago in Johannesburg with doctors talking about aging, and one of the doctors said to me, I am a physician. My job is to treat people's diseases with drugs. And I said, really? You know, is that the job of a doctor? You know, what about diet and stress and exercise and alcohol and so on? So what happens is, as you get older, you may lose your blood sugar control, and you may be diagnosed with diabetes or pre-diabetes, and you're given a drug called metformin or glucophage. Your doctor probably doesn't even know that it knocks out vitamin B12. And a lot of people on this drug get digestive disturbances. So you say, I've got some digestive problems. So now they stick you on Nexium, a proton pump inhibitor drug. This is one of the drugs that ends in azole, stops your body making stomach acid. They didn't tell you that that stops you absorbing B12, and it interferes with your ability to absorb minerals. So now your bones are getting thinner. And for your thinning bones, you're given, you know, bisphosphonate drugs. And by now, you're really getting mineral deficient, so your blood pressure is going up, and for that you're given an ACE inhibitor, and that knocks out zinc. This is very, very good money, but it's really bad medicine. Just to give you a couple of examples, in 2009 there was some very immaculately clear studies that showed that you don't give aspirin to someone to prevent heart disease for primary prevention. It should not be done. National Institute of Clinical Excellence, who advises doctors, say, don't do it. British Heart Foundation says, don't do it. So we monitored the change in prescriptions over the next 2 years as a result of doctors being told, stop giving aspirin for primary prevention of heart disease, and they went down from 32 to 31 million. Here's a recent report in one of the top medical journals. Following official guidelines which result in multiple drug taking, polypharmacy is one of the greatest but most invisible threats to health in the aging population. So we've invented a game in the book. It's called Snakes and Ladders. And you know Snakes and Ladders, you're trying to get to a healthy 100. So if you throw a 6, you land on this square, it says you've got high cholesterol, you take statins, and you slither down the snake, you can't think straight and your muscles ache. But if you throw an 11, you land on this, it says you've got heart disease, you take omega-3, and you climb up the ladder, your mood improves and your joints stop aching. And then you throw a 4 and you land on here, you've got heartburn, you take one of these PPI drugs and you slither down here, your bone mass reduces and your memory gets worse, etc., etc. These are medical snakes and DNA ladders. So it makes a phenomenal amount of sense to up your intake of nutrients as you get older. I do need glasses now. I take 4 things twice a day. A high-strength multivitamin, extra vitamin C with zinc in it, extra antioxidants, and essential fats. That's what I do. Cost me £1 a day. You know, less than half a Starbucks. Choice is yours. There's a stand behind here that has these if you want them. The next thing you need as you get older is a stable supply of glucose, a stable blood sugar, not too much insulin. The last lady who was talking, Marilyn Glenville, she will have covered this in some detail, but basically, as we lose our ability to control blood sugar, every time you eat too much carbohydrate, your blood sugar goes too high, your body makes insulin. Insulin takes the excess sugar and stores it as fat around your middle, so you start to get the muffin top. And over time, what happens is you become insensitive to insulin. So now you have more blood sugar highs and much higher insulin. Insulin drives up your cholesterol, drives up your blood sugar. And this whole pattern is called metabolic syndrome. And if everyone here was tested, half of you already have this. And it has one simple cause, and therefore treatment. But instead, you're given a drug for your blood pressure, a drug for your heart disease, a drug for your pain, a drug for your mood, a drug for your sleeping, and so on. Something really fascinating was discovered about 20 years ago, and this is not controversial at all. We know how to extend an animal's lifespan by 25 to 50%. And you do it by giving very, very low calorie, but very good nutrition. This is a fact. And there's something quite magical about very low calorie. It's not going to catch on, because, you know, we don't want to eat very low calorie every day. But last year, you might have heard of a study where they took 13 diabetics, and they put them onto very low calorie for 8 weeks. At the end of 8 weeks, 11 out of 13 no longer had diabetes. So there's something interesting that happens when you feed people very little calories, very high nutrients. The geneticists have now worked out what it is. And this way of eating affects genes. It switches off a gene that controls insulin, and it switches on a gene that is anti-aging. It improves the way antioxidants work in the body. And what's become very clear, the one that you want to switch off is called DAF3, or the Grim Reaper. And the way you do this is by eating a diet that keeps your blood sugar dead even, which is called a low glycemic load diet. And the gene you want to switch on, its nickname Sweet 16, is called FOXO. And having more antioxidants helps to do that. So the next myth, I'm only going to cover two, there's more in the book, is it's in the genes. Aging is in the genes. There's nothing you can do about it. You might have read in some articles in the papers about something called a telomere. This is your genetic information on the DNA, and on the end of it, there's this little thing called the telomere, and every time you copy a cell, the map, your telomere gets a little shorter. And now in America, for about $600, you can have a death test. They measure the length of your telomeres, and they'll tell you how long you're going to live. Anyway, it turns out that increasing vitamin D, increasing omega-3s, and increasing exercise, and certain kinds of exercise, actually lengthens the telomeres. And improving methylation, which is to do with all those B vitamins and the homocysteine. You know why women's bones shrink? It's nothing to do with calcium. I mean, I've been saying this for 15 years. All of the studies that have given women calcium, postmenopausal women calcium, have failed to change bone mass density. It's not about calcium. The major drivers of losing bone mass is lack of vitamin D, because you need vitamin D to fix minerals in the bone, lack of B vitamins, especially B12, because B12 makes you do methylation. Methylation builds bone. Lack of weight-bearing exercise, and in some cases, hormonal deficiencies. In the book, we go through all of this. So what's going to improve your genetic hand? In other words, you can switch genes on and off. You can't change the ones you've got, but you can switch on the good guys, switch off the bad guys by eating a low GL diet, by becoming more sensitive to insulin, which the mineral chromium does. That's one of the things that I take. Probably eating less wheat and dairy after the age of 30. It looks like we aren't actually designed to have these foods, certainly in the quantity we do. If I tell you I'm 54, I'm still breastfeeding from another species of animal, you probably think I'm quite weird. I'm talking about milk. If I asked you to name a wild animal that consumes milk as an adult, there is none. But you can get away with it in your 20s and 30s and 40s. But as you get older, you want to have less wheat, less dairy. There are certain nutrients like resveratrol, like zinc, like coenzyme Q, like vitamin D, that actually affect your genes in a positive way. So does resistance exercise. That means, pulling something or pushing something or lifting something, building muscle. And so too does fast twitch muscle exercise. In most sports, all of the action is in 30-second bursts. I've just been in Africa and I went on safari, and the animals are pretty fit, but they hang around not doing too much. But then everything happens in a 30-second burst. And that uses what's called the fast twitch muscles. So if you've got a bicycle at home, for example, you know, a cycle machine or something, and you just warm up, but then you go as fast as you can for 30 seconds, and then you slow down for 90, and then you do again for 30 seconds. That actually changes your genetic expression. And there was a study out last week confirming this. So this thing I call a low GL diet, which I'm going to explain in a nutshell to you in a minute, is absolutely amazing for losing weight. But it also reverses diabetes, and it reverses heart disease, and it reduces your cancer risk. One study said that 15% of breast cancer risk is attributed to eating sweets. Women's risk, smoking accounts for 30% of a woman's risk of cancer. Being overweight, significantly overweight, is 20% of risk. So again, you do something, this is how it works. You can measure the effect a food has on your blood sugar. It's called the GL. It's different to GI. And if you want to lose weight, you want no more than 40. You always eat protein with carbohydrates. So if you eat an apple, does it satisfy you? Not really. But if you eat an apple, carbohydrate with protein, almond, pumpkin seeds, chia, the effect is different. Jam on toast, sugar and sugar. Quick blood sugar burst, quick burst of energy. 1 hour later, you're hungry again. Egg on toast, protein and carbohydrate. You want to graze rather than gorge. The worst thing you can do is wake up in the morning, look in the mirror and go, oh my God, I'm too fat, and swear you'll never eat again. Your blood sugar is at its lowest, so you make yourself a strong coffee, which gives you a kickstart. And then you pass an innocent-looking fluffy white croissant, and you think that can't be much. It's 25 GLs, boring on its own, so you have 2 teaspoons of jam. That's another 10 GLs. So you just did 35 GLs on the day that you swore you would never eat again, and you haven't even got to 11 o'clock. So you have to have substantial breakfast, snack, lunch, snack, dinner. And I've written lots of books about this, which may be, you know, somewhere in the show. The book 10 Secrets of Healthy Aging also tells you how to do this low GL diet. So if it's breakfast and you fancy cereal and fruit, which is carbohydrate, where's the protein? There's a little in milk. There's more in soy milk. But if you were to put some of those chia seeds or almonds or walnuts, or this is protein. So you want to up the protein. If you had scrambled eggs on toast, that would be very good. I have this stuff. I don't know, there's a stand over here. Maybe that, I don't know if they're making it, but it's delicious. It's made of whole foods. I made it when I was in charge of a Himalayan mountaineering expedition, and we were living on it at 20,000 feet, and we'd mix it with snow, and it was quite nice. But it's better if you've got a blender and you put some milk in. I like oat milk and a handful of berries, spoonful of get up and go. And if I have this, I don't take my vitamins because it's already got tons of vitamins in it. So it's breakfast plus supplements. So what is 10 GLs? The GL is a measure of what the food does to your blood sugar. At this show, a rather rotund gentleman approached me and he said, I'm diabetic and I follow your basic diet and I'm gaining weight. Answer me this, he said in a rather aggressive tone, which is a hallmark of metabolic syndrome. And I said, what do you have for breakfast? And he said, I have oat muesli. And I said, he said, oats are good for you, aren't they? And I said, does your muesli have raisins in it? Does anyone here have cereal in the morning with raisins in it? Yeah. When you get home, pour out what you normally eat, take out the raisins and count them. The average bowl of muesli has 60 raisins. 10 raisins is 5 GLs. 60 raisins is 30 GLs. I then said, do you sweeten your cereal with anything? He said, yes, I have a whole banana. It's good for you, isn't it? And a third of a banana is 5 GLs, whole banana is 15 GLs, so he's done 45 GLs on the banana and the raisins. So his blood sugar will go up, he'll make more insulin, his diabetes will get worse. Two bowls of oats has the same effect as half a bowl of cornflakes. a whole punnet of berries. All of these berries has the same effect as these raisins or that banana. So there are just things you need to learn, and the effect is very significant. I also saw on that stand they have this sugar xylitol. Marilyn Glenville was talking about this in the last lecture. This stuff, cherries, 70% of the sugar in cherries is xylose. And when you crystallize it, it's called xylitol. And 9 teaspoons of xylitol equals 1 teaspoon of sugar. So in my birthday cake yesterday, this lovely dairy-free, wheat-free chocolate cake, they used xylitol. It was totally delicious. So if you have, you know, bread and egg, what do you have? You might want to have a pumpernickel-style bread or a rye bread. The best of all are oatcakes, because oatcakes are high in soluble fibers. That's what makes porridge gluey. It's because the fiber absorbs water. And you want to have the ones with the most rough oatcakes, because that's where you get the soluble fibers. When you have a snack, you know, some fruit with some almonds, maybe some oatcakes with some hummus, or a piece of, you know, whole grain toast with some peanut butter, or a small yogurt with some berries. You're always thinking protein and carbohydrate. I'm just giving you a, you know, this isn't difficult to do, and the book makes it very clear, but when you have your main meal, half is vegetables, 1/4 protein, 1/4 carbohydrate. There are a few nutrients that further accelerate weight loss, and one of them is called HCA. Whenever I eat out, I want to eat in a restaurant in a country where the people are thinnest and healthiest, and that means a Thai restaurant. And in the Thai restaurant, I ask for the dish with a tamarind sauce because it contains HCA. And HCA makes it much harder to turn excess carbs into fat. Chromium improves insulin sensitivity, and that stabilizes your blood sugar, and that reduces your craving for sugar. If you have low levels in your brain of serotonin, you have a low mood and a high craving of sugar. And you might know this. For some of you, when your mood is low, you could almost say it is guaranteed that you will eat something sweet. And this is usually because you have low serotonin. There is a drug that raises serotonin very effectively for about 6 hours. It's called MDMA, ecstasy. It's not available on the National Health Service. And if people have this drug, they cannot eat. Everything in your body, insulin, serotonin, adrenaline, hemoglobin, is made from food. And serotonin is made from an amino acid called 5-hydroxytryptophan, which you can buy. And people who do a low GL diet lose weight. Those who do a low GL diet and take these extras lose more weight. Superfibers. Chia seeds are high in soluble fiber. Oats are high in soluble fiber. But there is one fiber from Japan, which is called glucomannan fiber. And if you take a teaspoon, which is 5 grams, and you put it in some water, and you always have to have this with water, it absorbs all the water, it fills you up, it lowers the GL of your meal. It's another factor. I won't show you all of these, but this is somebody eating a meal. Up goes their blood sugar, out goes the insulin, down goes their blood sugar. This is a meal plus 5 grams of this super fiber, and their blood sugar is much more even. We use this a lot in people with diabetes. I get approached by people all the time who want to tell me their story. A few months ago, I got approached by this lady, or at least this is how she used to look, and this is how she looks now. She's going to tell you her story.
My name's Wendy, and I've been overweight my entire adult life. I've always been overweight. I've tried so many different diets and been to the doctors and come away crying because they can't help me. But then I went on the HOLFORD diet, the low GL diet, and I managed to lose 6 stone in just over a year. I've never looked back. I was diabetic with a HbA1c of 8.1. Now my HbA1c is 5.1. Anything over 7 is diabetic. My cholesterol and blood pressure are absolutely spot on as well. I can't tell you how much my mood has improved. Everything about my health and life has improved. I eat full, lovely, happy meals, full and satisfying. I get no hunger cravings. I'm never going back to the way I used to eat. Patrick's diet is a diet for life, it's not a fad.
Recently, a group of GPs approached us, and they were very interested in the GL diet. They didn't do any supplements, by the way, in this. What they did was they gave us a couple of dozen people with diabetes, heart disease, metabolic syndrome, you know, and normally these people will get worse and worse. And the best measure of blood sugar control is something called glycosylated hemoglobin, which means sugar-coated red blood cells. And it's called HbA1c. Every time your blood sugar goes up too high, the red blood cells get sugar-coated. So if you count the percentage that are sugar-coated, you know how many blood sugar highs you're getting. And the red blood cells last for 3 months, so it's a long-term measure. When you're above 7, if you don't have diabetes, you will do soon. So that lady, she was telling you, she had a level in the 8s, and now it's down to 5.1. And the doctor said, if you can lower this by 10%, we will be delighted. I mean, delighted. And anyway, in the 12 weeks, they lost 7 kilos, so over a stone as an average. You know, one person lost 14 kilos, that's over 2 stone. HbA1c down, cholesterol down, blood fats down, blood pressure down, everything down. No more need for drugs for blood pressure, drugs for cholesterol, drugs for blood sugar control. We have so many diabetics coming out of diabetes following this. I got an email, I was in Dubai a couple of months ago. A lady writes in and she says, I've lost 20 kilos, you know, over 44 pounds. My blood sugar, she's diabetic, is completely normal. My blood pressure is normal, my cholesterol is normal. No more drugs, thank God. So, in the book, we talk about the importance of weight, nutrition, less alcohol and stimulants, fewer drugs, exercise, the right ones, posture, sleep and relaxation. We teach you in the book how to get 7 hours good quality sleep. There was a study, and they did what we said, and these people slept on average for 5 hours, and at the end, it went to 7. Positive attitude, good relationships, sense of purpose. I don't have time to talk about all of these things. Sunlight, the role of hormones, sometimes nutritional supplements. A journalist last week asked me, in one sentence, can you tell me the secret of healthy aging? And I said, it's sex, no drugs, and rock and roll. And if you get your hormones good and your blood sugar balanced and your energy up, you know, you might be wanting a little bit more sex. And the no drugs, I think you understand. And the rock and roll is keep exercising, keep enjoying yourself, keep socializing. You know, not having a good circle of friends and relationships is as harmful, says one study, as smoking 15 cigarettes a day. So there are a lot of other factors. This is the book. A quick announcement. My name is Patrick Holford. My job is to help people be and stay healthy. I have a club. It's called the 100% Health Club. It costs normally £35 a year to join, and then I look after you. You get a newsletter from me every other month. I've done all these special health reports, everything you want to know about, hot flushes, cholesterol, soya, multiple sclerosis, Parkinson's, you name it. We have discussion groups, blogs. We have all sorts of stuff and ways of supporting you. And if you join today, and this is a today only, you don't get this on our website, we will give you a copy of this book, which will save you £15. It's £14.99. This book is not out yet. It comes out on April the 5th. And we have been given a few copies by our publishers. So if you join, we will give you a copy of the book. And the details are all over there. If you join, you can go to my website, patrickholford.com. You go to the advice section. You could click on health conditions. and you will see that we've written in-depth reports on all sorts of problems, from eye health to gout to endometriosis, you name it, often using top experts. So I will bring in the best experts that I can. And you know, that's the membership, so it's available for you there. The supplements I mentioned are over there. And also in April, towards the end of April, I'm going to be whizzing around Leeds, Edinburgh, Belfast, Dublin, Galway, Limerick, Cork, Bristol, London, Guernsey, and Jersey, giving lectures on arthritis, osteoporosis, say no to cancer infections, allergies, how to prevent Alzheimer's and balance your mood, say no to diabetes and heart disease and control your weight, and the 10 secrets of healthy aging. So if you'd like to know more in that context, we have a leaflet which you can take away for you. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much.
So that's it for another year. We'll be back with loads more action, but until then, see ya.